and we are underway. Well, it's one thing to have length, it's another thing to use it, and he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there by Slice.
Oh, oh, he tags him with the left. Strike here to end the fight early in the first.
Well, Joe, we've talked a lot about his technique and how technical a striker he is, and that was really the shot heard around the world to get the finish here in the first round. Again, maybe he caught the guy cold a little bit. He didn't have a chance to warm up, but that is a huge result for him here tonight, and on the other side, he didn't take much damage. So, big, big win for him here tonight.
And here we see it one more time. Look at the timing in this shot. Boom! Wow!
So a strong candidate for some bonus money there. A huge knockout for him here tonight. Near perfect execution. They'll be talking about this result for some time.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Deans called a stop to this contest at 21 seconds of the very first round.
Coming up next, it's a featherweight matchup between Conor McGregor and Max Holloway. Our tale of the tape now for this featherweight fight. Holloway is 26. McGregor is 29. Holloway is 2 inches taller. McGregor will have a 5-inch reach advantage.
Here we go, first round, you ready?
We are underway. Just inches away from landing one of those big right hands. Oh, that hook has been there all night. There's another one by McGregor. Holloway. Whoa!
He hurt him with that hook.
Oh, he might be out.
He's hurt.
Gotta fight, folks. The left hook hits home.
Oh, that left hook hurt him. What a performance by Max Holloway. Beautiful knockout here early in the first.
Yeah, Joe, that was the perfect shot right there. We didn't even get a feeling out process here tonight, and we say it all the... Now we go inside the... Coming up next, a welterweight tilt between Conor McGregor and Jorge Gamebred Masvidal.
Are you ready? Ready?
And with that, we are underway here at the Honda Center in Anaheim, California. High-level MMA defense there, able to avoid the punch. Nice job by Conor.
Huge
hook. Big hook. Let's see if he can follow it up.
Whoa, head kick.
Oh, man, another head kick lands. These are really starting to pile up now.
Oh, he hurt him. He's stumbling. Big punches here.
Just misses with that big right hand. All right, so a swing and a miss there, and largely due to fatigue. His stamina is low, and he's...
Oh, he hurt him! This could be it!
Oh, man, has his chin been tested in.
Big straight punch! Knockout strike here for the victory.
Well, Joe, you knew if he landed that weapon repeatedly, it could be a short night for his opponent, but that was just one perfectly placed strike that his opponent candidly didn't even see coming. It landed flush, and the rest, as they say, is history. Big knockout win for him here tonight.
Let's take a look at that again. Great angle here. And he's out.
Well, hard to perform much better than he did tonight. A huge knockout under the lights. They'll be talking about that one for some time. We send it inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has...
All right, straight ahead, we'll get to this lightweight bout between Donald Cerrone and Conor McGregor. And now our tale of the tape for this lightweight fight. Cerrone is 5 years the elder. McGregor will have a one-inch reach advantage. We set it inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer.
He stands 6 feet 1 inch tall, weighing in at 150.
Well, always great to be back in the Pacific time zone. We get underway here at the Honda Center in Anaheim, California. Good to have you with us for a night of UFC action. And he lands a nice kick.
He's teeing off with some good punches here.
Big left hand there inside. Well, straight right hand has been a good weapon for him. He misses with it there. Oh,
huge,
that is
shot
a big
with the
hook.
Hook.
We'll see if he can follow it up.
What a wild exchange. Really, oh, he tagged him. He tagged him with the right hand.
How about that shin?
Oh, he's hurt.
Striking technique to land that shot and ultimately finish the fight here in the first. You've heard us say it before, but sometimes when you catch a guy cold before he's had a chance to get going in the fight, it can have a bigger effect. It certainly did here tonight.
And let's see that again from another angle.
Now we go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Mario Yamasaki has called a stop for this contest at 1 minute, 19 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by...